Well, okay then. Look hard. See this pile of deer scat? It's fresh.
Yeah, I see it.
This way.
Yeah, I can see that.
Well, come on, man. There's your buck.
I see him.
Now here, use my rifle. If you were in the 10th Mountain, you know how to use a scope.
Yeah, Cope, I know how to use a scope.
Easy, easy.
I got this.
We got him. Nice shot.
Oh, goddammit, it wasn't a kill shot. He got away.
No, that's okay. You wounded him. He'll bleed out soon enough. We just gotta track him.
Okay.
See the blood spot? Look close.
Yeah, I see him.
Then follow him.
On it.
He'll be slowing down about now. Losing too much blood. We should be coming across his carcass anytime now. Okay, you know how to gut an animal?
Yeah, look. Cope, Boozer and I have been hunting before. He used to go elk hunting with his old man, and yeah, he showed me how to gut a deer.
Well, let's just say, no disrespect to Boozer, but you got a lot to learn. You're wasting a lot of meat there. Overall, not bad for a beginner.
Yeah, thanks.
Now, I'll take back that rifle.
Here, thanks.
Like I said, Deke, we can always use more venison at the camp. Still got some folks trying to heal up from that Ripper attack.
Okay, Cope. Yeah, I'll see if I can remember that.
How's it going, Booze Man?
Fine, damn it. Hey, Deke, we're getting low on supplies. We could use some more meat if you get a chance.
Shit, okay. Guess it's been a while since we did any hunting. I'll see if I can scare up some meat while I'm out.
Remember what you're doing.
Yeah, I had Cope give me a few pointers, believe it or not.
Oh, shit, I don't believe it. Thanks, D.
See you, Boothman.
Used to lay down salt licks. That's real sporting.
Guess none of that shit matters now.
Sarge, how about we make an unscheduled stop on our way?
What was that?
A couple of sample
trees. We are authorized to
shoot! We should be friends now.
On sight!
Sarge, how about we make an unscheduled stop on our way back? A couple of sample traps I want to check.
Hey, Doc, how long before your job's done?
I'm not a doctor. I keep telling you that.
Sorry. General problem. How long are we going to be here?
Only animals can become carrion, normal, not humans. You guys checked the perimeter, right?
Yeah, it's cool.
O'Brien, field note 2006. On approach to the landing site, I observed a large swarm of insects, probably Tibetosatronus or Diptera, in a clearing well away from our designated target. From that distance, I could not discern what was attracting the insects, but from the size of the swarm, recent carrion is indicated. It should be just over here. Damn it, where is it? Ah. Tibetosatronus is confirmed, but its pores are here. I have the suit on to tell you. The carrion is still mostly intact and appears to be Phytophorus lioneus or mule deer. I guess if anybody could check that. Striation of the larger muscle masses indicate infection of wounded strain HB. We'll take sample to confirm.
This way, you poor son of a bitch. At least you weren't torn apart by freaks. If you lived a few more weeks, you might have become one yourself, and I would have that been something. What do you want? Stay back.
I just want to talk.
Nero Protocol 2-7 states clearly that if conducting operations in quarantine zones, that if I encounter any civilians or civilians that I'm forbidden from making contact.
Really? See, that sounded to me like making contact.
Yes. Yes, it did.
You're alive.
Yes. I am.
How? How are you alive?
What? I don't understand.
Okay. You were there. That night. Farewell. The next night, with
Nero Protocol 2-7 states.
Everyone was dead. They were slaughtered. Torn limb from goddamn limb. All right, listen up. We're going to do this the easy way or the hard way. The easy way, we have a little chat. You give me the information that I need, and then you go back to digging your way through freaker shit or whatever the hell is you're doing out here. The hard way. I crack open that little space suit, and then we see what your friends out there have to say about you breathing in all this contaminated air. So what's it going to be, O'Brien?
Yes. Okay. Okay.
You remember the rooftop of the old brewery? I put a woman on your chopper. She was wounded.
Yes. I remember. A knife wound. She was cut pretty bad.
I went to the refugee camp that you said you were taking her to. Everyone was dead, so I'm going to ask you again. How did you survive?
We weren't there. We were diverted south to another camp. Like you said, the camp in Belknap was overrun, so they moved us south to a camp outside of Silver Lake.
Were there survivors?
You mean now? I don't know. I was transferred to the research unit.
Did she survive?
Oh, wait. I can find out. I can check. You have one of our radios. That's how you... I can't promise anything, but... I'll check.
Uh-huh, and I'm gonna go with you.
No, you can't. Please, you don't... Hey, you don't understand. I'll fucking shoot you.
Not before I shoot you.
Okay, look, if you're gonna fucking kill me, do it, okay? I did my job. Did that woman, your wife... I put her on oxygen. I gave her an IV. I kept her alive. I got in a lot of trouble for that. She was septic. She wasn't gonna make it, but I got her to the mass unit. I saved her goddamn life.
O'Brien, report.
Oh, I have to go. Please, you have to get out of here. You don't know these men. You don't know
Ryan,
what they're capable of.
If I don't hear from you, I don't care how long it takes. I'm going to track you down. And I'm going to do a lot worse than snap off an antenna.
I'm sorry about your wife. But you're not the only one who lost someone that night.
Is he alive? They were diverted south. He said that he put her on oxygen, he gave her an IV, he kept her alive. She was septic, so she wasn't gonna make it, but he got her to the MASH unit. He saved her life. He said it. He said he saved her life. She can still be. She can. No. But O'Brien is alive. If he is, then maybe. Man, a few days ago, I asked you if you remembered that Nero asshole, O'Brien.
Yeah, Deke, it's all kind of a blur.
Yeah, okay. Get some shut-eye, booze, man. I'll tell you about it later.
When are we riding out of here, Deke?
Soon, Boozer. Real soon. Look, as soon as your arm heals, we're gonna be riding the hell out of here.
Yeah, Deke.
O'Brien! Oh, you son of a bitch, you better read it. Hear me, O'Brien? You're on this channel? God damn it. You better get back to me or I'm going to track you down.
You got that?
O'Brien, he's alive. How the hell is he alive? They were diverted south. He said that he put her on oxygen, he gave her an IV, he kept her alive. She was septic, so she wasn't gonna make it, but he got her to a MASH unit. He saved her life. He said it. He said he saved her life. She can still be. She can. No. But O'Brien is alive. If he is, maybe.
Deke, you there?
Booze man. A few days ago, I asked you if you remembered that Nero asshole, O'Brien.
Yeah, Deke, it's all kind of a blur.
Yeah. Okay, get some shut-eye, booze man. I'll tell you about it later.
When are we riding out of here, Deke?
Okay. More bounties. Soon, Boozer. Real soon. Look, as
As soon as your arm heals, we're gonna be riding it. Look, as soon as your arm heals, we're gonna be riding the hell out of here.
Yeah, Deke. Okay.
O'Brien. Are you out there? O'Brien! Oh, you son of a bitch, you better radio me. You hear me, O'Brien? I know you're on this channel. God damn it. Okay, you better get back to me or I'm going to track you down. You got that? Oh, God damn it. Oh, come on! O'Brien! Get back to me.
Track down the chopper. Was it the same guy, the one we saw on the roof that night?
Yeah. Yeah, it was him.
And did he remember us? Sarah, what happened?
I don't know. They got diverted south. He remembered her, but he doesn't know what happened to her.
You don't think she's still alive?
What? No. I mean, no. Look, I'm not stupid, Boozer. I just want to find out, you know, what happened to her. Or she died. I don't need to find any peace. I gotta go, all right? Deacon out.
Hey, been staying a step ahead of him?
Hey, yeah, barely.
It's gonna get cold tonight.
Yeah, I can feel it. Hey, booze man, I brought in some meat. Should keep us stocked up for a while.
Hey, Deke, thanks, man. I'm not real hungry right now. I'll salt it up in a bit.
need scrap.
Thank you. opening the gate.
How's it going?
How you doing, kid?
They won't let me leave.
Why would you want to leave? It's safe here.
I have to work.
Okay. Okay.
My mom used to have a green thumb. I've killed every plant I've ever touched.
What do you want?
Deep, you ever ride with a drifter, scars all over his face, carries a tire iron, goes by the name of Limbo?
Don't know him.
He came into camp yesterday to turn in some bounties, have a few drinks. Seems like he didn't leave until early this morning.
Well, Tuck, I don't run security here, so why don't you just tell Alki about that?
He beat a man, Deke, and a woman to death. Bowman and Hewitt. Her face was so smashed in, you couldn't tell it was her.
Hewitt. Oh, Maria. Right? Oh, Jesus. Sasshole, Limbo. He's a local.
Alki says they've set up shop at the old Forest Service watchtower on the east slope of Three Finger Jack.
Yep, I know where it is, and, I'll handle it.
I thought you might.
An artist.
How you doing?
How's life in the hot springs?
What? You need something?
I think it's clear.
Here you go. Powerful. Good shot. You'll like this one. Thanks. What else can I do for you? Okay, sure. I'll let Tucker know you stopped by.
Deke, you there? I got bored. Figured I'd see if I remembered how to make anything. Stop by when you can, I think you'll like it.
Oh, booze man, yes. I always need more shit. Thanks, brother. Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Orange.
Shit, that's right. I gotta finish burning off this mess.
Back during the American Revolution,
oh, I smell a nest.
Fighting for our freedoms.
It'll be right here.
We gained the beautiful right to kill and bear arms. A right we use to protect ourselves, our families, our property. That is, until the ever-growing
worry,
federal
fellas,
government
I'll be
got
back
scared
later.
Of the people they swore
finish
to protect.
Burning you out.
Over the years, they stripped us of every gun right they could, using a few mass shootings as an excuse to curtail the God-given rights of us, American citizens. Gun control.
Then, son of a bitch!
The Second Amendment, ladies and gentlemen. Let me ask you this. When all this shit went down, if every American was packing heat, do you think we'd be in this mess? Hell no. But this is how the feds wanted it. Disarming the public was just the first step toward getting rid of us all. So who did those gun laws really protect? Sure as hell wasn't us, the American taxpayers. Someday, we ever dig out of this? I want to take a poll. I bet those who survived were those who had guns. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Okay, Cope, this time you got me. I'll take all the guns I can get my hands on. Ain't no one taking them away from me.
Bunch of murdering assholes can't let any of them get out of here alive.
Deke, thank God. You've got to go after him now. They're getting away.
Go after who, Tuck? Slow down.
It's Roach. It's Roach. You know him. He used to ride with Leon and Alvarez. But I trusted him.
Oh, God damn it, Tuck. You shouldn't have.
No, he's taking the rest of our drugs and headed north. My boys lost him somewhere around Marion Forks.
All right, I'll see if I can track it down.
saw someone out there. What was that?
How do you like that, huh? Okay, time for the rest of you.
Not moving!
Down. Let's do this.
Reload!
get in there.
Sit still, you bitch!
Now I got you.
Shit! Now!
Get down!
Back!
Yeah!
Now.
Here you are. We got him! Eat this, asshole!
Ah. Uh-oh.
scrap. I got a use for you. Okay. That all you got? Yeah, that's what I thought. Next time you set up an ambush, don't pick on the wrong guy. All right, where did you hide your bunker, huh? I know you got one.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. It's the Wild West again. And some men are acting like law and order are a thing of the past. Last I checked, this is still the United States of America. And in America, the right of property shall not be infringed. We have the right to claim territory, to hold it, and to defend it. Sure, we took this land from the Indians. No point in rewriting history, but we took it by force. And force is the only thing that will move us now. We're not gonna roll over for a bunch of bullies. If the feds, or rippers, or marauders think they're gonna come rolling into my wilderness, they got another thing coming. The strongest survive, the strongest take, and the strongest will succeed. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
That's something, Cope. Law and order are a thing of the past. What the hell are you talking about?
But yeah, you got a point about force being the only thing that matters now. Force. And a lot of goddamn ammo.
Hatch, yeah, here it is. Hello, a map. Looks like they marked it up pretty good.
I'm just gonna grab some shot eye. I'm ready to go back at it. Neat.
got you. This is it. Come back later, finish burning out these nests. Finally, Jesus.
Another bounty.
Tucker! I spotted him and it looks like he was waiting for someone.
Deke, don't let him get away. I want him alive.
Oh!
Fuck them to shit!
Tucker alive?
More shit has come up missing. I need him to tell us where he stashed it.
Okay. Hey, shit. Alright, I'll see what I can do. But come on, Roach! Where do you think you're going, huh? Still back here, you son of a bitch! Fine! Alright, let's do this the hard way!
Now I gotta tell you!
Better get away, Deke.
Roach, slow down! I just wanna talk!
Yeah? Why Tucker sent you? To talk?
Yeah, goddammit! If I wanted to kill you, you'd be dead!
I know what you've done to Leon and Alvarez.
Roger, are you late for something? Where are you going?
Hell with you, St. John.
You can't get away from me!
Shit, perfect time.
Let him get away, Deke. Get away, Deke.
How's it going, buddy? See? Told you I wasn't gonna kill you.
Deke, no. No, I didn't do nothing.
That's not what Tucker says. I guess when Leon and Alvarez took off with the camp's drugs, they forgot to cut you in. Is that about it?
Deke, no.
No, clue me in on what you're thinking, man. I want to understand. You took what was left while the old woman wasn't looking?
Oh, Deke, I got nothing on me, okay? Search me.
No, I'm not. It's not my job. I'm going to leave that up to Alki.
Hey, Tuck, I got him. Mark down these coordinates and have Alkai send some men.
What you did to Leon, okay, Deke? Please, man.
He's alive.
Come on, please.
Did he have my drugs?
Deke, no. Please,
yeah,
please, we rode together, remember?
You want him to stay
you
that
me,
way,
we
Alkai,
were friends.
You better hurry up and get off his ass. St. John out.
Please, please.
Hey, Boozman.
I don't want to die.
Yeah,
don't leave me out here.
Crazy
come on,
question.
Untie me.
Any idea where I
damn you!
Egg.
God damn you!
What the hell for?
The kid I brought in, just trying to find a way to cheer her up. She mentioned having one.
Shit, I don't know. Check the gift shop at Belknap Crater. Maybe Miriam Forks.
Yeah, okay. Thanks. Fuel can. Needed this. That should be it. Doesn't look too bad. Damn it.
seen that coming.
Won't be needing this. Scrap. Might be useful. Lisa, I...
Go away.
I brought you something.
It's beautiful. Will you take me with you? Take me back to Marion Forks.
Look,
Look, I can't, because it's not safe.
I gotta turn in. They make us get up really early for work.
Last time I was on the road, and it will be the last time. Ran into a pack. Thank God.
Let me get the gate.
How's it? Hey, I haven't seen Boozer around much lately.
Yeah, he's around. I guess he's just been doing more work for Copeland lately.
You tell him I said get off his ass and do some work for me.
Yeah, I'll let him know.
Maybe next time. Mm-hmm. See you again.
St. John F. Yeah.
Finally. Figures.
Like Weaver says, they hear a bunk calling my name.
Wait a second,
how's it going?
I got it.
Looks like you've got a few ears here.
Yeah, I got a drifter or two. We'll stop by now and then.
That's all I got for now.
I know. It's the best I can do.
Wait a sec, I got it.
Yeah, she was thrilled. Made her day. Hell, it made her fucking year.
I bet. Booze her out.
Yeah.
St. John, stop by Peaceful Lake when you get a chance.
Copeland, I hear you. St. John out. Good.
Okay. Okay, here we go. Should work. Thank you.
sniper. Gotcha, you son of a bitch. No more ammo strips for you, bro.
Do you see it?
Let's go.
You're looking kind of pale.
Not feeling great. I'm Camino right now.
Hey, you're not answering the radio.
Yep. I know, I was...
Well, hold on.
No, I'm all right. Just... trying to get clear, you know?
You're burning up.
Ugh, my head's pounding like a mother.
You're burning up.
No, I'm just tired.
Okay, stay here, rest. I'll think of something.
Look, I don't need a goddamn babysitter, I'm fine.
Here, come here, I'll show you what you're looking for.
Yep, found it.
All right, come on, focus.
I am focused.
All right, so this one is called Lavandula angustifolia.
Lavender?
Yes, well, I'm still paying off my student loan, so I will stick with Latin, mm-hmm. But you can call it that.
Yeah, get your money's worth, go for it.
Okay, come on, give me your hands. All right, so you want to put one hand around the flower.
All right.
And then put the other hand at the stem.
Okay.
Just like that, and then you pull nice and slow.
Yeah, I pulled weeds before.
Excuse me, sir, this is not a weed. You have to be gentle.
But apply pressure.
Oh, yeah, but not too hard. Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm.
Go. There you go, that's perfect.
And it doesn't smell very good.
Okay, you hold on to those, and I'm going to collect more.
So, why lavender?
Well, the guys at the lab are pretty excited. They think they have this subspecies, which might have mutated monoterpenoids, which produce a modified linalool that...
That is so... Oh, my... Thank you, Einstein. Thank you.
Sorry. It has a chemical that we can use to synthesize a new medicine for burn patients.
Where I'm from, the only weed used for medicine is the kind that you smoke. You know, Boozer knows a guy with a farm. It's about 3 miles up the road.
Oh, that's great. Boozer's gonna wind up in prison and take you with him.
So what else do you guys make? Like chemical weapons, WMDs, shit like that?
No. Well, at least not me.
Yeah?
It's in my contract. None of my research can be used for military purposes.
Hey, there's more over here.
Wait, stop.
Oh, come on, the water's gonna be great.
Hold on.
What's wrong?
Well, I didn't mean stop that.
Come on, what is it?
It's a long story.
Well, that's okay. We can just walk. I like walking.
So, why don't you tell me about your plants?
Really? Okay. Well, this particular genus is adventitious.
You want me to ask?
It means not native to this area. You can thank Ogden for that.
Who? Oh, shit, I asked.
Peter Skeen Ogden, first explorer to come through this part of Oregon. He and some of the other early explorers brought all their medicinal herbs and plants with them. Some got away, and now they're growing here. Mostly along the shores of small lakes and ponds.
First white explorer.
Wow, look at you, being all politically correct.
Don't buy into all the biker stereotypes you see on TV. We are actually quite charming.
I bet.
The MC's got a couple of brothers, one fully patched.
I don't think I've seen one person of color since I arrived in your strange little backwater paradise.
Yeah, Jack actually had some guys bust in from Sacramento just to piss off our skinhead rivals.
He did not.
No, he did not. I'm kidding. Jersey Jim's an old buddy of mine. Patched him and myself. We served in the same unit. Come by the clubhouse Sunday. I'll show you around. You'd like the guy. He's funny as shit. He makes a mean margarita.
Well, I have to be in the lab early on Monday, so...
I'll have us back in your bed by 10. I promise.
How can I refuse an offer like that? Okay, you try picking some now.
Lavender. You want me to pick lavender?
Yep. And bring me 3 plants and don't crush them.
Oh, I'm gonna crush them.
Come on.
Got one.
Good for you.
This one?
Yep, keep going.
Last one.
Great, bring him here. Oh.
For you.
Wow, Gallantry is alive and farewell after all.
Oh, if he's not, then I didn't kill him.
Hey! Aw, poor guys.
Hey, is that the one we're gonna smoke later?
No, but this is the one we're gonna drink. I make this killer herbal tea with it.
I'll bet.
Hey, all right, if you come over, then I will make it for you as long as you give me a ride home.
All right, great.
You're gonna be a believer.
And we'll grab a beer for myself on the way over.